What is spirituality according to you?
I'm going to spend some time on it because it's such an important question to explore. You see, all religions and even youngsters today, if you ask them, are you religious? They say, no, we are spiritual. They'll tell you that. But if you quiz them, what do you mean by spiritual? They'll fumble about. They don't know exactly what. So the word spiritual has been loosely used all over the place and somehow it's lost its potency. It's a very powerful word, and what does it really signify? That's what I'm going to explore in a very short time. Spirituality, you know, if you try and get a handle on what is meant by spirituality, some kind of articulation, some kind of vocabulary, you always fall short of the target. Surprisingly, it's difficult to encapsulate the idea of spirituality, and yet it is very visible in our routine lives. It's not something airy, fairy, woolly. It is very visible with ordinary human beings, not high philosophers, ordinary human beings. This is what spirituality means. There are certain aspects to us. We become revealed, you know, for example, we are in search of kind of truth. What is all this? Be knowledgeable. We're also in search of things like, we also like the idea of being compassionate. It seems to flow naturally from all living things, not just human beings. Natural kind of affinity for other living things, maybe their close, you know, kith and kin or the family or the friends or whatever. There's natural compassion flowing from every living thing. Okay, so there's this compassion, this idea of search for truth, of being knowledgeable. And there's a third aspect very crucial about all living things, and that is we like to kind of master nature rather than be buffeted by nature. We don't like being pushed about. One of the unique features about all living things, even a single cell bacteria or amoeba, doesn't like being pushed about. So there's something which shows a living thing as what it is living by in a way expressing itself, saying, I don't like to be buffeted by forces of nature. I wish to harness the forces of nature and sit above them. I'm not in compliance with the forces of nature. I'm in fact in defiance of forces of nature. I want to control them rather than be pushed around by them. Unique feature about all living things. Now you see, you've heard enough. Now this is what he said. Just in our ordinary life, this thing that appears as compassion, searching for knowledge, being kind of empowered. You may think this is just natural thing springing out of a human body, human being. It is not. It is a reflection of the underpinning that we call spiritual. The only way spirituality manifests or becomes visible in our ordinary life, forget about high philosophy, ordinary life is through this idea of being compassionate toward the living things. Whenever we have this natural compassion, in a way we are that spiritual underpinning we have is revealing itself, becoming expressed in our lives. So all these kind of, I just touched on three features, but all these features in a way reflect a deeper dimension to our being, which is difficult to kind of capture, and yet we use the nearest word. Suppose you say, oh, Mr. Lakhani, can you define love? You'll be in great trouble. So same way, I suppose, say, how do you mean you want to be empowered? What does it mean? You know, you're just being pushed about anyway. So all these features that kind of we already exhibit in our routine, normal life are in a way reflecting what is meant by spiritual. So all of us, ordinary people, are living a spiritual life when you're being compassionate, we are searching for knowledge, becoming empowered. All these ideas are already reflecting our underpinning, which is not prepared to be controlled by others, which is to kind of express itself through its mind and body. And that, if you like, is one of the handles we have regarding what is meant by spirituality. It's difficult to encapsulate, and yet almost everything we do is in a way shows the underpinning, which is best defined as spiritual. It doesn't come out of matter, you know, this lump of carbon that got wound up. There's something expressing itself through this, you know, this frame, and that is essentially spirit.